Zhang Ce died 912, courtesy name Shaoyi, was an official of the Chinese dynasty Tang Dynasty, and the succeeding later Liang of the Five Dynasties and Ten Kingdoms period, serving as a chancellor during the reign of later Liang's founding emperor Zhu Quanzhong. Background. It is not known when Zhang Ce was born. His family was originally from Dunhuang. His father Zhang Tong served as a Tang Dynasty official and at one point reached the position of governor of Rong District Rongguang, headquartered in modern Yulin, Guangxi. At one point, Zhang Ce lived with his family at a mansion in Luoyang. At that time, an ancient-looking ornate ding was found in a well that bore in seal script the inscription sculpted by Jai Kaiyan in the spring, the second month of the first year of Wise Huangchu era, i.e., 220. Zhang Tong much valued the find, but Zhang Ce, who was then only 12 years old, calmly stated to his father, "In the 25th year of the Jianan era, the Lord Cao died. The era name was changed to Yankang. The 10th month of that year, Emperor Wen accepted Han Dynasty's offer of the throne, and at that point he declared the era name Huangchu. Therefore, there was no second month in the first year of Huangchu." How wrong this text was. Zhang Tong was surprised by his son's assertion and checked with the records of the Cao Wai portion of the records of the Three Kingdoms, which verified what Zhang Ce stated. The entire clan was amazed at Zhang Ce's knowledge. However, instead of going into Confucian studies and preparing for an official career, Zhang Ce was devoted to Buddhism in his youth. Even before he took adult clothes, he decided to take tonsure and became a monk at Xian Temple Sai and Si at the Tang imperial capital Chang'an. Late in the Guangming 880-881 era of Emperor Zizong of Tang, the Chang'an region came under attack by the major agrarian rebel Huang Keo. Hearing of the attack, Zhang Ce returned to civilian status so that he could take his parents to flee the disaster, and was much praised by the gentry who heard of this action. His father died soon thereafter, and he observed a period of mourning. Even after the period of mourning was over, however, for over a decade he did not seek an official appointment, but rather effectively became a hermit in the wilderness. Governmental career. During Tang Dynasty. After spending the time in the wilderness for over a decade, Zhang Ce entered imperial government service and served as a scholar at Guangwen Pavilion Guangwenguang, and later Miss Hu Lang Mai Shu Lang, an assistant at the palace library. When the warlord Wang Xingyu served as the military governor Ji Duchy of Jingnan Circuit Jingnan, headquartered in modern Xianyang, Shaanxi, he invited Zhang to serve on his staff as Guangcha Jishi Guancha Jaishi, an assistant to him in his role as governor Guanchashi. Later, when Wang ran into disputes with the imperial government and was attacked and defeated by Lai Qiong, the military governor of Hedong Circuit Hedong, headquartered in modern Taiyuan Shaanxi, fellow refugees sympathized with him, and this news spread. When Lai Qiong's arch-rival Zhu Quanzhong, the military governor of Xuanwu Circuit Xuanwu, headquartered in modern Kaifeng, Henan heard of this, he invited Zhang to serve as his assistant in his role as governor of Xuanyi Circuit Xuanyi, headquartered in modern Anyang, Henan. However, soon thereafter, Zhang's mother died, so he left governmental service to observe a period of mourning for her. After Zhang's period of mourning was over, he returned to the imperial government, serve as Guozi Boshi, a professor at the National University Guozi Jian, and then Shanbu Yuan Wei Lang, a low-level official at the Ministry of Rights Libu. After less than a year, the warlord Han Jian, the military governor of Zhengguo Circuit Zhengguo, Headquartered in modern Wainan, Shaanxi invited Zhang to serve as his secretary and later, when Han became the military governor of Zhongwu Circuit Zhongwu, headquartered in modern Zhecheng, Henan, Zhang served as chief secretary. During the Tianfu 901-904 era of Emperor Zizong's brother and successor Emperor Zhezong, there was an occasion when Han had Zhang bear letters and gifts from Han to Zhu. When Zhu saw Zhang, he gladly stated, "Professor Zhang is here." He retained Zhang to serve as chief secretary on his own staff. Early in the Tianyu era starting 904, shared between Emperor Zhezong and his son and successor Emperor Ai, Zhu recommended Zhang serve as Zhifang Langzhong Zhifang Langzhong, a supervisory official at the Ministry of Civil Service Affairs Libu. Libu, note, different tone than the Ministry of Rights and an editor of Imperial Histories. He was soon thereafter made an imperial scholar. Han Lin Zushi, Han Lin Zushi and Bingbu Langzhong, Bingbu Langzhong, a supervisory official at the Ministry of Defense, Bingbu, Bingbu. He was also in charge of drafting edicts and editing the Imperial History. Shortly after, he was made Zhangshu Shiren, Zhangshu Shiren, a mid-level official at the Legislative Bureau, Zhangshu Sheng. In 907, when Zhu had Emperor Ai yield the throne to him, ending Tang and starting a new Later Liang as its Emperor Taizu, Zhang served as the assistant to the Chancellor Yang during Later Liang. After Emperor Taizu took the throne as Later Liang Emperor, Zhangxi was made the Deputy Minister of Public Works Gongbu Shilang, Gongbu Shilang, as well as Chief Imperial Scholar Han Lin Zushi Chengzhai, Han Lin Zushi Chengzhai. Later that year, he was made the Deputy Minister of Rights Libu Shilang, Libu Shilang. In 908, he accompanied Emperor Taizu on his campaign against rival state Jin, then ruled by Lai Qiong's son and successor Lai Kungsu. Shortly after, he was made Deputy Minister of Justice Xingbu Shilang. He was also put in charge of the Directorate of Taxation Panhubu, Panhubu, and shortly after made Zhangshu Shilang, Zhangshu Shilang, the Deputy Head of the Legislative Bureau. Retirement and death. In late 908, Zhangxi sought retirement due to illness. He returned to Luoyang. He spent the rest of his years on his garden planting trees and enjoying books, music, and wine. He died in the fall of 912. He left a collection of his works, 3 volumes of his policy arguments in front of the emperor, 20 volumes of poetry and songs he wrote, and 30 volumes of his communiques. Notes and references. History of the Five Dynasties, Vol. 18. New History of the Five Dynasties, Vol. 35. Zizhai Tongjian, Vols. 266, 267.